He went inside to rescue Benny!
Clark! Clark!
I really thought I was going to die in there. It feels so good to be holding you right now.
You rushed to help. You didn't even think about Leia. If anything happened to you, you wouldn't have been able to give me a grandchild. But I like what you did. You're brave, and I admire you for that.
Thank you, Sir... Your Highness, Sir Saul.
Just call me Dad.
Leia!
Oh, why would you do that?
I scared you, didn't I?
What sort of person wouldn't be scared? I really thought that there was a ghost in the house.
What if I really am a ghost? Because even though I'm always around, you never seem to notice me. But just like a ghost, I'll always be here, haunting you. I'll be always in your thoughts, always in your dreams.
I've had enough of this. I don't want to love again.
I really can't blame you for feeling that way. If they love you, they'll come back.
I'm the mother of Leia.
I was the one who went with Leia when we had to go around looking for your grave. We went around all of San Francisco, and the entire time she lived here, she refused to even consider giving up the search until we finally found where
you
were
buried. Because love is temporary. It can go any time. I'm sorry, Clark, but my heart is too much of a shattered mess right now to allow me to trust anything.
There you go again, pushing me away again. I just want to be here, okay?
If you keep focusing only on one thing, like obsessing over Leia, you're never going to be happy. Why don't you go out? Make new friends, have fun!
You're all right with me, son-in-law.
Mr. Saul's pretty nice. And he suggested that I live with him. Leia doesn't want me there.
But why, sir?
It's complicated. But I'm not giving up.
You don't want McKenny, but it's from your mom, right?
I can't take care of McKenny anymore, Tholites. I'm really sorry, McKenny. I hope you understand.
Leia, are you okay? You seem sad nowadays. You're not as cheerful as you once were.
Really?
Do you know when you really seem happy? When Clark comes over here.
Yee?
You're very cheerful when he's around. And even Tiffany's changed, did you notice? What are you both going through?
I gotta go now. I'll see you later.
Did Uncle Clark leave already?
Oh, yes, Gabby.
I was really looking forward to playing some basketball with him.
Is that so? Don't worry, he promised to be here next Saturday.
But Aunt Leia, why are you smiling?
What? Me? Smiling?
You were smiling when you were talking about Uncle Clark.
I wasn't.
Don't you have a date tonight?
I'm done, Mom. I can't find decent girls in San Francisco.
Come on, Jiggs. Why do you even have to go to those random dating sites? I've told you before, you know? I know a few nice girls here.
Forget it, Mom.
Just this once. I mean, just try. After this, I'll shut up, I promise. Just do this for me.
Who is she?
Annie's niece. She's like you. Broken-hearted.
What do you want us to do? Vent frustrations, cry all night, is that it?
Just try. If this doesn't work out, I'll shut up and stop. Just do this for me, okay? And besides, you never know. If she doesn't help you, maybe it's you can help her out. All right?
Hey, come on, let's dance! Come on, we'll just dance! Come
hey,
on,
what's
everybody,
your problem,
let's
baby?
All dance!
What's going on, man?
There's this crazy chick in there. She's picking fights with everyone. She's crazy, man.
Can you just stop it?
That girl's just like me.
So these are the things I'm doing for the cafe.
You're very, very artistic.
I really want this to work. You know, I want a stable business for us.
Oh, Clark, That's not just for us. It's for you and Leia, too.
I have Leia in my future plans. For her, I can do anything and everything.
Wow.
Are you Maggie?
Dude, what's your problem?
What? What did you say?
Oh, no problem.
Are you Maggie?
No.
I heard you were looking for me.
Huh? No, I wasn't. Wait. Maggie?
How do you do?
Clark, come on. You just left the house, and now you want to go out again?
You can't blame me. I just want to see you before you go to sleep.
Come on, Clark. We could have talked over Skype or something.
I want the Leia that I can touch. I can look in the eyes. Come on, 10 minutes.
Ten?
Okay, five. Three. Two. 1 minute.
1 minute?
1 minute to just be with you. To hold you. And I'll be okay.
Clark, come on.
10 minutes starts.
1 minute.
1 minute starts now.
Time's up. All right, my work starts early tomorrow.
You're pushing me away again?
I'm not.
Are you afraid I'll find out? Well, I know.
About what?
That you still love me. Even if you don't say it, I know it.
Why do we keep talking about this, Clark?
Because you've been avoiding this for weeks. Even me. You're avoiding me. Pushing me away. Leia, do you want me to do it again? Enter a house on fire so you can realize you still love me? Because if that's what it takes, Leia, I'll do it.
Don't! I can't take that.
Why? Why? Leia, why? Say it! I need to hear you say it! Why?
Because I don't want to lose you! Because even now I still have feelings for you! Because I love you, Clark! I love you so much!
See you. If I could see you, if I go out my way, see you, if I could.
Don't.
Why?
I love you, Clark. But I'm not sure if we should still be together. There might come a time when we'll only be hurting each other.
Leia, I know you're hurt from what your mother did to you. But not everyone around you is like your mother. I'm not like that. It It's not just about love. It's about trust. You can trust me.
I want to trust you, Clark. To believe in us. Sorry, but I'm not ready yet. Maybe one day I could take it. But not right now. I'm so sorry if I'm hurting you. But now I'm trying hard. I'm just not ready yet. Sorry.
Please tell me, Grandma. I love Leia. And I know she loves me. But why the obstacles?
That's why they're called challenges. You're both being tested by fate. To see just how strong your love is for each other. But Clark, you must understand that Leia is broken. She needs more time.
But Grandma, I'm fighting for our love. But she can't commit. I tried to understand her. I tried to be patient. But sometimes I get tired too.
But those who truly love are ready to wait. No matter how long it takes. Just ask yourself, Clark. How much do you love Leia? Are you willing to wait for her for a very long time?
I'm sorry. I just wanted to get closer, but I scared them away.
It's quite all right. They'll come back soon enough.
When I was little, my mother and I used to feed the pigeons all the time.
Where's your mom now?
She passed away.
I just started doing this maybe 2 weeks ago. It was around this time that I came here and they all suddenly arrived. So since then, it became a daily ritual for me and the pigeons. But there are days when I come here and they are not around. So I wait for them.
Don't you ever get tired of waiting?
I've learned to love these pigeons a lot, you know, because as they say, if they love you, they will come back again for sure. If you love someone, you should be ready to wait.
Why are you still here? Why did you come back?
Because someone told me, if they love you, they'll come back.
Come on, McKenny. Crew, please eat. You'll starve.
Hi, the lights. How are you? Is McKenny giving you a hard time?
Ever since you gave him to me, he's been sluggish and won't eat. Oh no, Leia. Your sister will be mad at me again if something happens to him.
Do you think he's sick, though, Lights?
No, I think that he just misses you. Pets are kind of like people sometimes, you know? They see it coming when they are unloved or abandoned. They get upset.
I'm sorry, McKenny. Even you're caught up in this. I love you, but I'm not ready to see you every day again. Not yet.
Leia, you okay?
Tolites, the reason I gave McKenny to you was because you're very caring to others, so you can shower him with love.
I can't even do that for Tiffany. And now McKenny?
So you're giving up now?
No way, not me.
Good to hear. Please take care of McKenny, okay?
Okay, take care.
Hi. Sorry I'm late. So, let me formally introduce myself. I'm Jiggs, son of Jack, friend of your Aunt Annie.
Let me informally introduce myself. I'm Maggie Regalado from Balikbalik.
Wait, you speak Tagalog?
Yeah. Tagalog, Waray, street slang. I've only been here 5 years, so don't try too hard to speak English. That won't work on me.
What?
Hold on. Waiter! Water, please!
I don't try hard speaking English. I speak it well.
Okay.
Water.
Thank you.
This girl's so cranky.
Wow, so finally, Jiggs and Maggie are already going out.
Really? That's good for Maggie then, Jack.
Goodness, Annie. I really hope this works out for all of us. You know just how much Jiggs needs this date.
I really hope
Jiggs can stand Maggie.
What? Why?
Well, she's okay.
It's just that
what?
She's just not your typical
girl next door type. She's not typical. Period.
So, what are you doing for a living? Like, what's your job here?
Nurse.
But how'd you get here? Did you get petitioned? Well, so how?
Through work.
Are you alone here, or are you with someone?
You know what? I'm sorry, but this is kind of corny. No offense, but this whole fixed dating thing, it's all shih tzu!
Shih tzu? What does that mean?
Well, my aunt doesn't want me saying any of the vulgar words, so I figured I'd find another way to call it. Shih tzu! Anyway, as I was saying, this whole fixed dating thing, it's shih tzu! Okay?
Hey, you're a jerk. You think I wanted this? I'm doing this as a favor for my mom.
Wow. Thanks a lot. What a gentleman you are, truly. So, if this whole thing is a mere favor, what are you still doing here? Let's not waste money, you know. Listen, here's what. Tell your mom we went on a date. I'll tell Aunt Annie that we met. That you were kind, and it was wonderful. But there's no spark. Okay? Okay, I'll see you. Take care of the bill, okay?
Huh?
Thanks, bye!
What an annoying girl.
So why are you here every day, sir?
Because my wife is confined in a hospital nearby. She's been in a coma for almost a month now. Her name's Sylvia, by the way.
I hope Mrs. Sylvia gets better.
I hope so. But the doctor said that at this age of ours, she might not wake up anymore. They said it's impossible. So I told them, nothing's impossible with love. Ah. All right then, son. I'll see you later.
Are you going back to the hospital?
I am, in case Sylvia wakes up. She'll already see me by her side and just waiting.
All right, All right, listen up. We're going to be working on a very important project, so I want all ears and all eyes on this one, okay? I just received a brief and we are to do a full ad campaign for a juice brand. But we have to think of a very creative, a very witty, and a very catchy tagline for this one. Because it wants to infiltrate the Philippine market. So we have to sell gallons and gallons of this juice with that tagline. Whoever thinks of a good tagline, he or she might be really, really compensated well by this company. And depending on your performance, you might get a promotion, okay? Everyone, good luck. I want to see those creative briefs on my desk this week, okay?
Okay, sir.
Okay?
Okay, thank
yes, sir.
You.
Good luck, everyone.
This is our chance. It's our chance to show off and prove to the boss that we deserve higher positions and salaries.
Oh, Leia, don't get your hopes up. There's no chance our ideas will be chosen. They'll prioritize the proposals of the senior writers. That's how it is, so I won't put up much effort, okay?
Oh, come on, sir. When did you become such a pessimist? We never know, right? For me, I actually need that huge bonus and promotion. It'll be a big help for my family. So go, push! I'm going for the win.
Well, I'm not. Let's go.
Hey. Hey, baby. What's your name?
Go to hell.
Hey! You want me to call the cops on you? Rats! Hey!
Don't! They're gone now. Just let them be.
Let them be? Those scumbags are going to get it from me.
You should be really thankful I stopped you. Those kids, they have a known modus operandi for the newbies. They want you to chase them so they could lead you into an ambush. You should be grateful. I saved you. And can you stop shouting at me? Fudge! Brownies.
Fudge brownies?
Leia, I want to go get lunch.
I'm fine.
Are you sure?
Yes.
Yeah, I'll go ahead.
Part-time job will do.
I'm sorry, Rana, but I'm afraid I'm overstaffed right now.
Is that so? I'm getting my last unemployment check at the end of the month, so I don't have any idea where I will get the money for next month's rent.
Don't worry. If I find something, I'll call you immediately.
All right. Thank you so much. Brent? You're going to miss the school bus again.
I don't understand why I have to be that loser kid that has to ride the bus. Why don't we have a car anymore?
Son, as soon as I get a good paying job, we'll be able to get a car again. Here, eat now.
Now we're having leftover pizza for breakfast? Again?
Well, but aren't you going to
eat? I lost my appetite. Mom, what happened to us? Ever since Dad died, everything has just been going downhill. I don't feel like we're a family anymore.
Brent!
There's something important I want to tell you.
What is it, Clark?
I want to fight for Leia's love. I know that if I do that, Jiggs will be upset. I know it'll cause trouble for us. But I love Leia. I can't deny myself that feeling. I hope you understand, Grandma.
I do know how you feel right now, Clark. Because I have felt it all before. You know, your Grandpa Paquito and I, we also fought for our love against all odds thrown at us. You see, your Grandpa Paquito, he did not have my parents' approval because he wasn't from a well-off family. But Clark, our love was greater. than all the riches in the world combined. And on the issue between you and Jiggs, we'll have to pray for that, okay? So you two could be on good terms. I understand you, Clark.
Dad, it's already late. I remember I told you not to wait up for me. You should go to sleep.
How can I sleep when I know you haven't come home yet? Did your boss ask you to work overtime?
Oh, no, Dad, no. It was my choice, because we're working on a big project with incentives. Who knows, I might just get promoted. That'd be great.
No questions. I'm certain they'll love whatever you submit. You're a real go-getter, just like me.
You got that right, Dad. I hope I do get promoted soon, so wish me luck, Dad.
You know, Leia, if only your husband Clark were here with us, I'm sure you'd be able to relax.
But, Dad, you know the guy has to make a living, right?
Well, it's still very different when you go home to your loved ones after a long day of back-breaking work. Just like me. My fatigue and stress from driving disappears whenever you and your mom welcome me home. Well, I don't know. Why don't you just live in one roof?
Dad, his project requires his complete attention. Besides, I feel relaxed because, unlike others, I do go home to my loved ones. You're one of them, Dad. Come on now.
Here, have some coffee.
I'm really sorry for bothering you.
Oh, it's nothing. I'm always here to listen to family.
Thank you. It's just that Brent is lost. He thinks our family's broken. Actually, I feel the same way about things. I may have escaped his father, but now, being trapped in limbo for so long, I don't think I know how to live freely again. I don't know where to go anymore.
Isn't that how it is sometimes? We often stray from the right path. I went through that with Jiggs. The same situation where you feel you don't know where you're going. And trust me, I've been here a long time too. But I always remember, I shouldn't give up on the people I love.
We're different, Jack. You decided to leave your son behind because you needed to work here. But you didn't abandon him. You didn't turn your back. But me? I left my family. And then I lived with another man.
I hope you don't mind, okay? I want to ask you something. Do you still love your family? There's, Tiffany. There's Leia and Saul.
I do. I love them.
So, in that case, even if they push you away, reject you, criticize or curse, you should accept it for now.
And then, make sure you get to prove your love for them.
Wow! Clark! The cafe you're supplying furniture for looks amazing! The owner must be really rich!
That's right, and she'll be here later. So, mind your manners. Sit down on that table, and finish your homework there.
Sure, Clark.
Are you okay?
Clark? Looks like the cafe will be done soon.
Yeah. A little more furniture, some designs, then it's done.
And after that, you're going back to San Francisco, right?
Hey, Jenny. Don't be sad. I'll do everything I can for us to stay together. Whether I'm here or in the States, I'll never let you down. Were you just being dramatic so you could avoid doing homework?
Of course not!
Clark.
Diana.
Hi. Clark, this is my daughter Angela.
You're the bartender, right?
Yes. I'm surprised you remember.
You know each other? How?
Let's just...
Angela, I was asking Clark.
Oh, your daughter was in a little bit of trouble at this bar I used to work at in San Francisco. I just helped her out. It's no big deal.
And I'm pretty sure you're downplaying that. But you know what? Never mind. I think the interior designer is here.
Hi!
Hi!
Hello, Clark.
Hi, Joanne.
Well, since everyone's here, shall we look at the designs?
All right, okay. Let's. This is the divider, right? I was thinking if you don't mind, we need to match this. Overall, I like it. You were able to deliver what I asked for. The cafe is chic and classy, definitely. But I want more.
If you ask me, I think it's too chic. Too Western. What do you think, Clark?
Oh, no. I'm not an interior designer, so...
It's okay, Clark. We need to work closely together, so your feedback is important.
Okay, well... As an overseas worker... I would like to see more of... the Filipino design.
You're right. It's better that, upon entering the cafe, there's a sense of nostalgia.
And romance.
Sorry?
Well, it might be a bit weird, but when I first arrived here in Manila, I saw romance. It's warm, it's full of love. That's the first thing that hit me. The heart of Manila and its capacity to love.
All right. So, romance and nostalgia.
Yes.
That's what we want. Thanks for your input, everyone. And Clark, you made some valid points.
Thank you.
And you, Angela, I'm glad that you're finally expressing your opinion. That's why I keep on insisting that you go back to art school.
Here we go again, Mom. I already told you I came here to the Philippines to help you and accompany you. That's it. Nothing else, Mom.
All right, fine.
Hubby... Why don't you visit or call anymore? Maybe you got fed up waiting for me. I miss you, hubby.
Joanne, to be fair, you've been away for a while too. So, maybe the Manila you remember is no longer this Manila.
I realize that, and I'm sorry, you know, as much as I want to go around Manila to do my research, I simply can't.
But the cafe opens in a month.
I know.
Clark, can you help me out? Would it be possible to show me the Manila you saw when you came here? Show us the difference with the Manila now and the Manila you remember as a child. Right? That's a good design standpoint.
Yeah.
It'll work.
I can help with the design research. All right, then. I'll see what I can do. I won't leave this country until I'm sure that you're satisfied with the look of your cafe. At least when it comes to furniture, I can show you the designs that capture how romantic Manila really is.
Romantic?
Romantic and nostalgic. Boss, just leave it to us. We know exactly what to do.
Really? Nostalgic?
Nostalgic?
Spell it out.
Nostalgic. No, I can't do it. You do it. I'll do romantic instead. R-O-mantic. Romantic. Rock's not dead.
Guys, this is serious. We really need to prove to Mrs. Diana that she made the right decision with us. We need to bring out the romance and nostalgia that she's looking for. We have to rediscover Manila again.
Then, sir, why don't we just join you and go around the streets of Manila? That way we can help you find what you're looking for.
That's right.
Really?
Yeah, that's right.
You can help me with that?
Sure.
You're not playing me, right?
We'll do it.
You'll rediscover the beauty of Manila.
Sir, welcome to the 8th wonder of the world. Traffic in the Philippines!
Boss, it really makes you wonder. Look, there are no accidents. It's not raining or rush hour, but the traffic's still heavy.
Come on, guys. Manila's still beautiful. We just have to know where to look.
This is my favorite place in Manila!
Great. Still about food.
Careful, you.
I like the food, but we need to find a place that's, romantic.
Romantic, boss? I know a place that's very romantic. When I want some love, I go there. Woo-hoo.
Really? Where?
Here it is. I told you, boss. This is where we can find love.
Hi, sir. Why didn't you come yesterday?
Huh?
I was waiting for you.
I'm busy at the shop.
Why?
I have a lot of... Boss?
Huh?
Boss, are we going in?
What's this place, Kiko?
I'm really sure about this. Chan!
I don't think so.
Leia, what's that?
It's the ad campaign for the juice. I'm going to present this to my boss tomorrow.
Wow. My baby? Acting like an executive.
Not really, Dad. Just an office girl.
Dear, I noticed that Clark hasn't been visiting lately.
Well, because it's a weekday, Dad.
But the past weekdays, he used to find ways just to visit you. He'd pick you up from the office, or ask you out somewhere. But he seems quiet lately. Did you have a fight?
No, Dad. Maybe he's just busy with work.
Maybe? You don't know? Doesn't he call you on the phone anymore? What kind of husband is he? Just because I've approved of him? He already stopped courting you? Is that how he is? Oh, my opinion of him can still change.
Dad, please don't. Clark's not like that at all.
Then what's happening with you?
It was actually my fault, Dad. I told Clark to stay away for now.
I thought you said you love him.
I just want to be comfortable with our relationship before I finally commit.
My goodness. I can't understand kids these days. You have so many issues. Clark loves you. And you love him, You're already married, so you should be together. It's as simple as that.
But Dad, my point is, we don't know if this love will last forever. Even if Clark and I are loving each other, how do we even know if it's meant to last?
Nothing is certain in love, Leia. It's a gamble. I know that it's terrifying, but what if this is the eternal love we've all been dreaming of all this time? But you've given up before it started. Are you throwing that away?
Leia, why do you look so tense standing there?
Well, I'm waiting for a chance with Miss Tanya.
Why?
I wanted to show her my original idea for our blue chip client.
Wow, you really took it seriously? So why show it to Tanya? Why don't you go straight to our boss?
I wanted to show her first because I'm hoping to improve it. But you know, I don't want her yelling at me again. Pray for me.
Honey!
It's a good thing you made
it. Hi, Jigs.
Hi, hello. How are you?
I missed you.
Hey, Russell. Hi. She must be Maggie, right? Mm-hmm.
She's our niece.
Hello. Hi, Maggie. Of course you remember my son, Jigs.
Yes.
My handsome son. Hey, Jigs. It's Maggie, the niece of your Aunt Annie.
Oh, goodness. By the way, Jigs, thanks for saving Maggie at the street the other day. Your mother told me about it.
Don't pass by mission again, okay? It's full of goons, you know. Remember that.
Yes, sir.
My son's really got a bit of that hero complex, you know? He really likes defending people around him. And also standing up for other people, so I'm glad Maggie's safe.
Yes. You!
How about it, Jigs? Want a beer?
Sure, sir.
You're really a bad influence.
Waiter!
What's your order? Go ahead.
It was Mom's idea, going for dinner when it's obviously a setup for us.
It's your own fault for impressing my aunt. You saved me, didn't you?
I wasn't trying to impress your aunt, okay? I just told my mom what I did. I didn't know she would tell Miss Annie everything.
Ah, so you told her. You helped me. Hero syndrome.
My mom just asked me why my shirt was dirty. So I told her what happened. She just assumed the rest.
Aw, you're my hero.
You're crazy.
Miss Tanya, good morning.
Leia, I'm very busy.
I know, but this won't take long.
What?
It's about that project Sir Rav told us. Well, this is my idea.
What's this? Oh, my juiceness?
Well, since I know we need to sell a lot of juice, I thought of the tagline, Oh My Juiceness. It's very new, witty, and has mass appeal.
Yes, you can say that, but it's cheap. You're making the imported product look cheap. Next time, if you're going to say something to me, make sure it makes sense, okay? Can you just leave?
I'm sorry.
Just let her be.
So, why don't we do this again?
Yeah, why not?
Or, if you find this corny, you two can go on your own.
Why not tomorrow?
Yes.
I have to go.
That's right. Maggie.
See, I told you so. That woman will shoot you down for fun.
But maybe she's right. My tagline sounds kind of cheap. I don't really know anything about being classy.
My goodness, Leia. You're a good copywriter.
I was just hoping for a chance to get promoted and get a bonus. But it looks like I still have a lot to learn.
I have the best team
Sir?
Working on it. Yes, Tanya. What's up? Ah, okay. Wow.
Oh, my.
Come here.
Let's Isn't that your folder? One.
Okay, this looks good.
You're right, sir. Do you think Sir Rav likes it?
He looks happy. I think he does. Clark? What are those for?
I need to familiarize myself again with the special places in Manila.
Familiarize? How can you do that by just staring at those pictures? Shouldn't you at least visit those places?
Well, I tried, but all I got was cheap thrills from Kiko and Axel.
Why don't you ask Leia to go with you, Clark? I'm sure that she knows a lot of beautiful places.
She's right, Clark, and it'll be more romantic.
All right, guys. I'm very happy to announce that we already have a winning campaign for our overseas client. I think it's fresh. I think it's fun. Basically, I think it's perfect.
I guess he's chosen a winner.
There's no surprise, actually, that this campaign came from the brilliant mind of one of our senior copywriters, Tanya Zamora.
Oh my gosh. Thank you, boss. Thank you.
Congratulations, Tanya.
Thank you,
I like
boss.
Your tagline. You are so awesome. Oh, my juiceness.
Thank you.
Wait, Leia, I think that's your tagline, right?
It's perfect.
Thank you.
I hate her. The nerve of that woman, you know.
Thank you, boss.
She acts like an angel, but she just stole an idea. Goodness, Leia, you better get used to her. As long as that woman is our boss, she's going to keep stepping all over us. It's crazy. Anyway, let's forget about her. My ride is here. Are you okay? Smile. We'll talk tomorrow in the office, okay? You'll be fine. Goodbye.
Leia. I know you don't like it when I do this.
Clark.
But...
See you if I could.
Hey, what's wrong?
See you if I
it's so unfair, Clark.
See you if I could.
It's okay. I'm here.
Just say you'll never go, say you'll never go.